Is there anywhere we could shut that ventilator back there?
Shut the what?
Well, I think with...
fans, wrestling fans around the corner, around the world, can you see or hear us? It appears we are live here in Sin City, Las Vegas, Nevada. I don't know if you can see that in the background. I know you can see Alex Din fan roaming, but the man of the hour, a man that has not been with us in this fine organization since he cut the hair and threw it on top of his grandmother, the man that is now known as Viking Raider Ivar in WWE, the one, the only, multi-time WWE Intercontinental and European Champion, Mr. D'Lo Brown. D'Lo, so happy to have you back with us.
Well, thank you for having me here. It's a pleasure to be here, and it's for a good cause and good time and good people, so I'm happy.
Well, fans, as you may know, we are trying to get things rocking and rolling for the Wrestling Insiders annual Paul Bearer Holiday Headlocks toy drive. Yes, it is a little early for Christmas. Yeah. The summer is still ongoing. I have on my finest Santa Claus shirt for the interviews we're going to take tonight that are going to be airing in the holiday season. But the great thing about the Cauliflower Alley Club is it's so easy for us to hook up with some talent that's, you know, more difficult to have to fly out and worry about flight delays and cancellations and issues with hotels and transporting around the Boston area. So we thought this would be fun. We bring all this equipment out here every year anyway to try and help the Cauliflower and record the reunion. So we lined up some great guests. In addition to D'Lo, Kevin Sullivan is going to be with us on Wednesday morning. The Godfather is going to be with us Tuesday afternoon. That's Pacific time. We have some other folks that we don't officially have guaranteed yet, which is why we didn't put them on that beautiful photo that D'Lo is going to sign. That's going to be part of the great Holiday Headlocks VIP package as we get closer to Christmas. But right now, we have got four different D'Lo 8x10s. If you click the link at the top of the screen, D'Lo right now is doing a little Vanna White action. I still haven't allowed him to speak.
It's okay. This is me with the coveted European Championship. And this is me with the lovely Intercontinental title. And then this is me with the lovely Deborah. And oh, yeah, I got both belts there, but I got Deborah next.
And a couple of puppies.
Yes.
Quincy Restani would be almost orgasmic right now if he saw those pictures of the puppies. But Quincy is back in Boston. But four different pictures for you guys to pick from. I'm sorry we started so late. We have had so many technical issues at this hotel, and they're not one, but two rooms that we have, which has driven me absolutely insane. And they keep saying, contact the manager, you know what? When you have 53,000, and certainly not your numbers, 53,000 on Twitter,
yeah,
they don't like getting those tweets.
No.
So that can help get a little customer service sometimes.
That gets things rock and roll when you get the Twitter mob going and helping you out.
And so, you know what? Boston Wrestling Warriors are some of the great fans. I saw my friend Phil is in the room already tonight. He's one of our group. Ferdinand, how are you, my friend? Eric, welcome to the room. If you guys could share the link, tell your friends where we did unfortunately start more than a minute or two late. You know, let's get some fans in here. It's for a great cause. Wrestling Insiders, we try and bring you unique guests 7 nights per week on video, not podcast style, you know. That takes a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of money for us to take the time to lug 6 suitcases filled with video equipment to Las Vegas when most people want to come to Las Vegas to do things that don't involve lugging 6 suitcases of video equipment.
Well, it depends on what they do for a living. A lot of people do bring cameras here.
You could be right about that. I know it's funny.
Probably in this hotel someone's filming something right now.
You're a wise man. An entrepreneur.
Yes, sir.
Now, this one in the background here, he's a very active man.
Yeah.
We'll call it politically correct. He's an active man.
Okay.
I said, what if we started a website for him where his name is Ben Fan? Only fans.
Thank you.
No. And then the tagline underneath, no, not that one. Onlyfans.com, no, not that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, look at these beautiful pictures here. They can be yours.
For the low price of $19.99, you're helping a great cause.
We will slide right by that description of the OnlyFans.
D-Lo is, and I want to get more into it on video, but any memories of our dear friend, a man that was like a second dad to me, that started this joy drive with me and John Cena back in 2012, a few months before he passed, the one, the only, Paul Bearer.
I love Paul Bearer. He was one of the...
Who doesn't say that?
I think if someone says they didn't like Paul Bearer, I think you need to examine who you are as a person, not who he was. He was always kind and gentle with me and would give me words of advice. He's known me since my time down at Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And then when I went up with him and you know, take her into WWE, he was always so just nice to me. He would always have his country music playing and his big old buckle belt. But, God, I love that man. Uncle Paul, I'd hug him right now if he was here.
He used to come almost every year to the CAC. He loved it. He loved what it stood for. He loved it. You know, when it was a more of a club for the boys, you know, mm-hmm. I think it's great for the club itself to try and, as far as the fundraising goes, to include as many people as possible.
Yes.
But there was a time when it was more for, quote unquote, just for the boys, so to speak.
No, I think that's missed
a little bit. You know what I mean? But
yeah, I know the history of the alley, and it was all about, you know, the boys having a place to get away, but. You know, I think if we've all noticed and realized something over the last 18 months, the relationship between the boys and the fans is one of symbiosis. It's without one, there's not the other.
Yep.
And you need both sides of this to make it work. Yes, we can go out there and wrestle empty buildings, but it's just not the same. And you can clearly see the difference between, you know, the empty arena shows and the feel and the work rate compared to when you fill that building up, and now the boys get to feed off that adrenaline. So I think one thing has been totally proven in the last 18 months is we need each other to make this business work.
Now, what is your official capacity with TN?
I'm the head of talent relations.
Really?
And I'm the color commentator for Impact Wrestling.
Really?
Yes.
I didn't know you were the head of talent relations.
Yeah, that's the tough job.
And you guys kind of really just got back into the thick of things as far as having live fans,
yeah,
right.
We just brought live fans back at the last set of TVs, at our last pay-per-view and last set of TVs, and we're continuing that. I'll be in Nashville on Saturday. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, so we're filming again. We have fans there, and then we come out here to Vegas in October, and that'll be our first kind of arena-type show since the world shut down, so... We're looking forward to that.
And how do you enjoy the TNA experience? I know you were there way back in 2003 when you were mm-hmm. fresh off of WWE, and I think you and Jeff Jarrett and Raven were involved in the big world title.
Me, Jeff Jarrett, AJ Styles.
It is a company that has certainly evolved.
Yes. No,
as time has gone on.
It is not even the same company that when I left, like
right.
when I finished up in 2012 there, the last time. It's a whole completely different company. I mean, Scott D'Amore has and Ed Nordholm have really reimagined what the company is and the way it's presented, and it's coming off in such a cool way for the fans now that we're giving, you know, a lot of good talent an opportunity to show themselves out to the world and giving, you know, hopefully good entertainment and enjoyment to the fans.
And what was the